我是维尼。每一个成语背后都承载着先人的智慧和人生的哲理。成语的典故你都知道有哪些？今天分享成语的典故双语版，一起来学习。
凿壁偷光
Bore a hole on the wall to steal light。
匡衡出生在一个贫穷的家庭，他非常喜欢读书。
Kuang Heng was born in a poor family. He liked reading books very much.
他白天需要干活，所以他不得不在晚上读书。
He needed to work at daytime, so he had to read books during night.
但是他太穷了，买不起蜡烛。
But he was too poor to buy a candle.
有一天，他发现邻居家有蜡烛，但光亮照不到他家。
One day, he found his neighbor had candles, but the light couldn't go through his room.
匡衡就在墙壁上凿了洞引来邻家的光亮，让光亮照在书上读书。
So he dug a small hole on the wall so that he could use the light to read books.
从那天起，他每天晚上都读书，直到灯光熄灭。
From that day, he read books every night until the light went out.
然而，他读完了所有的书，却没有书可读。
However, he finished reading all his books and there were no books for him to read.
于是他去了一个富人的家里，无偿地为他干活。
Then he went to a rich man's house and worked for him without payment.
富人问他你怎么不要报酬呢？他说，我希望读遍主人家的书。
The rich man asked, why don't you want the money? Kuang Heng said, because I only want to borrow your books.
富人听了，深为感叹，就借给匡衡书。
The rich man agreed. Kuang Heng read the books one by one.
于是匡衡成了一位伟大的学者。
Finally, he became a great scholar.
凿壁偷光形容家贫而读书刻苦。
This idiom story is used to describe someone who studies or works very hard.
掩耳盗铃
To cover one's ear while stealing a bell.
从前有一个小偷，看见邻居家大门上挂着一个铃铛，想把它偷走。
Once upon a time,There was a thief saw a doorbell hanging on the neighbor's door. He wanted to steal it.
但他知道，那个铃铛只要用手一碰，就会叮铃叮铃地响起来，被人发觉。
But he knew that bell would ring as soon as he touched it. And then he would be discovered.
他想，响声要用耳朵才能听见。
He thought, only using ears can hear the sound.
如果我把耳朵掩起来，不是就听不见了吗？
What if I cover my ears? Then the sound would not be heard anymore.
于是他掩住了自己的耳朵，伸手去偷那个铃铛。
Whereupon he covered his own ears and tried to steal the bell.
谁知手刚碰到铃铛，他就被人发觉了。
However, he was discovered immediately when he touched the bell.
掩耳盗铃比喻自己欺骗自己，瞒不住的事情还要想法掩盖。
This idiom is a metaphor for those that lie to themselves and come up with ways to cover up a problem that clearly cannot be covered up.
邯郸学步
Learn to walk in 邯郸。
战国时期，燕国寿陵地方有一位少年。
During the Warring States period, a young man lived in 寿陵。
他总觉得自己并不像自己想象的那么完美。
He always felt that he was not so perfect as he thought.
有一天他在路上碰到几个人说说笑笑，只听得有人说邯郸人走路姿势那叫美，所以他决定在那里学走路。邯郸人走路的姿势究竟怎样美呢？
One day, he heard that people in 邯郸 walked in a gracefully way, so he decided to learn to walk there.
于是一天早上，他瞒着家人跑到遥远的邯郸学走路去了。
One morning, he set off for 邯郸 without telling anyone.
一到邯郸，他感到处处新鲜，简直令人眼花缭乱。
Upon arrival at 邯郸, he was surprised when he saw the situation.
每个人都以不同但优雅的方式走路。
Everyone walked in a different but gracefully way.
看到小孩走路，他觉得活泼；看见老人走路，他觉得稳重。
Children walking actively, the old walking steady.
于是他决定学习一下邯郸的赵国人是怎样走路的。
So he made up his mind to learn how the people of the state of Zhao walked in 邯郸。
不管他怎么努力，他都学不懂那里人的步态。
No matter how hard he tried, he was unable to learn the gait of the people there.
就这样，他甚至完全忘记了自己在兽林是怎么走的。
On the contrary, he even forgot completely how he walked in Shouling.
最后，他别无选择，只好爬着回去了。
In the end, he had no choice but to crawl back to his hometown.
邯郸学步比喻盲目地模仿别人不成，反而把自己原有的技能也丢了。
People use this idiom to describe someone who imitates others blindly only to lose one's own individuality, advantages, and skills.
囫囵吞枣。
To swallow in one gulp.
从前，有个人买了一堆水果，有梨，也有枣。
Long ago, there was a young man who bought many fruits, like pears and dates.
有个老头看见了，对他说，小伙子，梨可不能多吃呀。它虽然对牙齿有好处，可是吃多了对身体不好。
An old man saw him and said, "Eating too many pears is good for teeth, but bad for your body."
青年人就问，枣吃多了呢？
The man asked, "How about dates?"
老头说，枣对身体是好的，可吃多了对牙齿不好，也不能多吃。
The old man answered, "The dates are good for body, but bad for teeth."
青年人看了看梨，又看了看枣。想了一会儿，说，哈哈，我想出了个好办法。
The young man thought for a while and said, I've got a good idea.
我吃梨就只用牙齿嚼，不吞到肚子里去。
I can eat pears with teeth and don't swallow them.
吃枣，我就把它整个吞下去，不用牙齿嚼。
And I can swallow dates without chewing.
说完话，他就拿起一个枣放在嘴里，直接吞了下去。
Then he put a date into his mouth and swallowed it immediately.
没想到，他一下子就被枣噎住了。
Unluckily, he was choked by the date.
囫囵吞枣，比喻不经过分析辨别，照原样笼统的接受。
This idiom is a metaphor that does not add analytical thinking to things.
杞人忧天。
Groundless fears.
一个杞国人，每天都担心天会掉下来。
In the state of Qi,There was a man who was haunted by the fear that the sky might fall.
为此焦虑的吃不好睡不好。
He was so worried that he could neither eat nor sleep well.
他的朋友开导他说，天是由气聚集而成的。
His friend said to him, "The sky is gathered by gas."
我们就生活在空气中，天是不可能掉下来的。
We are living in the air. It is impossible to fall.
杞国人听后顿感放心。
After hearing this,The man set his fear at ease instantly.
杞人忧天比喻缺乏根据或不必要的担心和忧虑。
It refers to unnecessary or groundless worries and anxieties.
同舟共济。
Cross a river in the same boat.
春秋战国时，吴、越两国连年交兵。
In the spring and autumn period, the state of Wu and the state of Yu didn't get along well. They had been fighting against each other for years.
两国百姓彼此在感情上也很难共融。
People in each country also didn't have a good relationship.
有一次，吴国人和越国人碰巧共乘一条船渡河。
One day, the people of Wu and the people of Yu happened to be on the same boat to cross a river.
开始时，他们都不理睬对方。
At the beginning, they didn't say a word with each other.
船至河心，狂风骤起。
When the boat sailed to the center of the river, a strong wind came.
霎时惊涛骇浪迎面扑来，船随时有可能覆没。
In no time, huge waves hit people's faces. It seemed that the boat would sink at any time.
此时，他们忘记了仇恨，相互救济，好像一家人一样。
Just then, they forgot all the hatred between two countries and began to help each other just like they were family.
由于全船人的齐心协力，终于安全到达对岸。
In the end, they safely got to the river bank under everyone's effort.
同舟共济比喻团结一致，共同战胜困难。
It is a metaphor of unity and mutual assistance, working together to overcome difficulties.
自相矛盾。
Piercing your shield with your own spear.
古时候，有一个人在市场上做生意。
A young man ran a business in the market.
他既卖矛又卖盾。一天，他在集市上叫卖。
He sells both spears and shields. One day, he is peddling in the fair.
他举起他的矛说：“我的矛非常锋利， 无论怎样，坚固的盾都能戳进去。
He held up a spear and said proudly, "My spear is very sharp. No matter how strong a shield is, my spear can pierce it."
说完，他又举起他的盾，夸口说：“我的盾非常坚固，无论怎样好的矛都戳不穿它。”
Then he held up his shield and bragged, "My shield is very strong. It can stop any spear in the world."
有人就问他：“那么，现在我用你的矛来戳你的盾，看看结果会怎样呢？”
Then one of them asked, "Well, what will happen if I pierce your shield with your spear?"
那个人窘得连一句话也答不上来。
The young man was too embarrassed to say anything.
自相矛盾比喻说话做事前后抵触，不一致。
It is a metaphor for when you say or do conflicting and contradictory things.
今天学习的成语的典故你都记住了吗？如果你喜欢今天的这个视频，可以去我的频道查看更多你喜欢的内容，还可以点击下方沉浸式英文对话列表，沉浸式的学习亲子英文。我是 Winnie， 请点赞收藏打开小铃铛，期待下期的精彩内容哦。